Hello everyone and welcome to episode 5 of My Can Enough. Sherlock's secretive first investigation. Who stole the spare key to the teacher's lounge? Conduct an investigate to find out who do need. Of who did it. anyway, we play episode and we are gonna do a story play and I hope I'm getting the illustration with Lysander. I had some time before class starts. I'm curious to get to know the family Lysander a bit better. I should go and talk to him. Hey, you are barely right. I'm Peggy. I'm in charge of the school newspaper. Hi. Great to get to the point. I heard that you saw a ghost in the school at night, and that you even ran an investigation on the subject. What can you tell me about it? What do you mean? Did you discover anything? Do you know what it is? Or what happens here at night? No, not really. It's just let me investigation. It's just, I just let my imagination get the better of me. That's all. Really? I hope you are not hiding anything from me. One day or another, I will figure out the truth, you know? No, really. We heard the voice coming from the student council. It sounds like the principal is yelling at Nathaniel. Becky went to see what's going on. Turn on your heels and avoid any trouble. I started to head away from the hall and I saw the principal leave the student council room. I wonder what happened. The thing followed the principal for a bit and saw me in the hall. You were there, you heard everything? No, in fact I was just going by and I saw the principal leaving here furious. Someone stole some documents that our kids saved in the teacher's lounge. It was you? Of course not, but the teacher's lounge is always kept locked and I'm the only student who has a copy. I think I understand. My key disappeared and the principal thinks I have something to do with it. I can see why. But I have nothing to do with it. Someone stole my key and then stole the documents from the teacher's lounge. If I don't get this sorted out very quickly, and the principal said I will be expelled, I don't know what to do. I will try to help you. Can we go look in the teacher's lounge? We might find something there. No, like I said, I don't have the key anymore, and I'm not allowed to go in there until this is settled. Okay, I will go see what I can do then. Whoa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 objects. Thank you, Melody. Sure. Nathaniel left, the poor guy. He looked really upset by all of this. It's understandable. He realized being the student body president and takes it seriously. Oh, did you hear that? The student body president is in the hot seat. That would be a great hotline. I can wait to find out more about this case. It is a scoop. See you later. You will find all about it in my article. The principal has been furious recently. Yes, I know. You haven't seen a key by any chance? No, do you need help looking for it? No, that's okay. Thanks anyway. Hi, Lysander. We met the other evening, you know, the ghosts and everything. Hello, Melody, right? That's right. So you and Kesha are good friends, right? We know each other for a while now, yeah? Did you hear Nathaniel is in serious trouble? He lost the key to the teacher's lounge and some stuff got stolen. And this concerns me how? Don't you think we should try to help him after all? I just told you I'm not concerned at all with any of this. Why would you be? Hi, my name is Melody. I'm Capucine. Oh wait, Melody, you say? So you are the one Amber told me about. What do you mean? Anyway, this is not a question. I'm looking for a key. Have you seen one? A key? No. Okay, thanks. Hi, Melody. Do we know each other? No, my name is Melody. Nathaniel told me about you. Really? When? What did he say about me? Oh, it was just after you got here. I helped him out with the paperwork. Oh, really? Are you the student body vice president? No, I'm just a delegate for my class. But that doesn't stop me from helping out from time to time. I see. Do you know anything about the lost key? Yes, isn't it terrible? I wonder who could have done it. Yes, I wonder too. Hey, we haven't met, have we? Aren't you the little girl that arrived a few weeks ago? Yes, that's me, Melody. I'm Kim. See you around, little girl. Wait, I'm looking for a key. You haven't seen one, have you? Nope, sorry. Haven't seen a key. Well, thanks anyway. Why did she call me little girl? I'm not as small. Hi, my name is Melody. Hello, I'm Violet. I'm looking for a key. Have you seen one? No, sorry, I didn't notice anything. Okay, thanks anyway. I still haven't seen a key, if that's what you want to know. I'm trying to help Nathaniel find the key for the teacher's lounge. Have you seen it? No. Would you tell me if you knew something? Of course. Do you have any idea you could have done it? Maybe I'm right. Yes, Santa Claus, I'm sure. What do you think? Thanks, Castle, as helpful as ever. Talk to almost everyone about this. No one seems to know, of course. I have a tiny idea about the guilt of Black. I think it was Ember who did it. That must be it. Okay, I still have to find the stupid key. And because we said it was Ember, who was also a little bit of a spoiler, the one who really did it. But that means that we will get. This hat. You don't get it until the end of the episode, but I'm already showing it to you. Anyway, we get back to the episode. Come on, tell me the truth. I will get all settled and won't say anything, promise. Yes, the truth is that I have nothing to do with this, and you're starting to get on my nerves. Oh, it even went lower, but I didn't make any choice. Do you know about the key for the teacher's lounge? What's there to know? The spare key has a key. Keys have gone missing. Keys don't disappear by themselves. Yes, I'm going to keep looking for them. Maybe Nathaniel just misplaced them. Could be, but I don't think so. Hey, you're a specialist for stealing keys, aren't you? What about the one for the door under the staircase, for example? I told you I have nothing to do with this. Stop getting on my nerves and go look for those keys. And I please don't ask him anymore, he gets only mad at me. Kiss you, if you ever find the key, don't forget to let me know, please. I'm not going to look for it while you keep hiding at exposition. Find it yourself. I don't mind looking for the key, but do you have any idea where it might be? If someone stole it from me, I have no idea where it could be. I usually leave it in the dishes lounge when I'm there or have it on me. It's okay, we will find it. One little key in their entire high school, and if someone has it on them, good luck. I not hope you're not going to start interrogating me again. Were you aware of the fact that your brother is in trouble? Of course I'm aware of it. Are you helping him look for the key as well? Because you're helping him, well, he doesn't really stand the chance of getting out of this then, does he? Mostly, have you seen a key? A key? No. Why? Did I lose my keys at home? She started to go to her pockets. She started to search her pockets. Double up. No, I lost the key. I'm looking for it. Oh, no, then I haven't seen a key. Sorry. Okay, thanks. Still haven't found the key. They must not be far. I'm going to keep on looking. You know, I'm not sure the key is the link, but rather something in the dishes and what exactly was stolen. I'm not allowed to talk about it. Okay, I will stay focused on the key for now then. I'll think about it. Okay, it's your call. Wait, well, actually, the documents were stolen where the upcoming exams. They are kept locked in the teacher's lounge, as you can imagine. Oh, I see. Don't worry, you will find them. Please tell me you found the key at least. No, sorry, I will get right back to it. Do you have any idea who could have stolen the exams? Of course not. It would be so weird if I know who did it. Someone who knew who put you in a difficult situation? Are you thinking of Cashel? No, he wouldn't do that. Because you know him so well, right? Well, my LM with him is very low at the moment. Let me know if you found the key. I still haven't found the key. Oh, I was wondering if you'd be back around here. Right. I found this famous key completely by chance. Here, take them. Super, thanks so much. You're welcome. Betty, any news? Yes, I found your key here. That's great. Thank you very much. Now I just have to find the upcoming exams in Bearstone. Do you think we should look in the teacher's lounge for any clues on who could have taken them? I'm already a suspect. If someone sees you or me in the teacher's lounge, that would not be good. But if you don't find exams, it won't be good for you either. That's true. Are you sure you want to risk it? I'm not sure, but I want to know who did it. Thanks, that's nice of you. This is what I suggest. We check the hall, and as soon as the principal is not around, I will open the door to the teacher's lounge for you. I can only get you in once, and be quick, before someone comes, okay? Okay, I understand. The principal is walking up and down the hall with her bad mood face on. And there is the principal again. And she is here again. It looks like the principal went back to her office. Are you ready? Yes. Follow me. I'm going to let you in the teacher's house. Follow Nathaniel. There, if you find any clues, enter the teacher's house. Okay, here we are. I just need to look around to see if I find anything. Where do you want to look? Search in the file cabinets. There's a file with someone's name on it. This is none of my business. Put the file back in its place. Continue the search. Where do you want to look? Search near the chairs. You found the places. It's a bit worn and cheap. It's certainly not a teacher. It must belong to a student who stole the exams. Continue the search. Where do you want to look? Leave. I'll have all I need. Oh, I have everything I need. Leave. I've looked everywhere. Now I just have to get out of here without getting... what are you doing here? I... Leave immediately, and I'm warning you, young lady. If there is anything missing, I will hold you responsible. Yes, I... Excuse me, ma'am. Sorry, I asked the student to bring these photocopies here for me. The teacher I helped the other day. Oh, really? I'm sorry, young lady. You can go. Phew, you really saved me. I will have to help out teachers more often. And if you look close, you see here are some bubbles. And now you have found the shorter pipe. I think it will be here. Yes. Okay, back to the episode. Well, that could have been worse. I could have been in more trouble. I was wondering, do you wear bracelets? No, I never wear jewelry, and especially nothing like that. I should have guessed that. Oh yeah, did you find anything in the teacher's house? Yes, I found this bracelet. Do you recognize it? No, not really. Tell me if you found out whose it is. Can I see the bracelet that you showed me earlier on again? Why? Yes, why? Does it look familiar? I'm not sure. Is this your bracelet? No, but I wish it was. It's pretty. I found a bracelet in the teacher's lounge. I hope you don't think I wear that kind of stuff. No, of course not. Do you know who it belongs to? I don't know, maybe. You don't want to tell me? Why would I tell you? You haven't stopped accusing me from the beginning. I'm sorry if I've falsely accused you. I know that it wasn't you. Sure, well, come back later. We'll see if I'm in the right mood to tell you anything. Lisander, I was searching the teacher's house and I found this bracelet. Do you recognize it? No, sorry, that's okay. I saw your academic file as well. I'm saying it again, directly. What? Did you read it? No, I didn't dare. That was smart. You would never have seen my fall under normal circumstances, and too much curiosity is a bad thing. But you never talk about yourself. Well, I only know him just yet. That's the way I am, that's all. And there's nothing extraordinary to know about me. So this bracelet, will you finally tell me who it belongs to? No, but why? It's not very nice. Well, look, I don't know, like I pay attention to the kind of stuff. Does this bracelet look familiar? No, not at all. Are you sure? Yeah, we already told you. Besides, it's way too ugly. Well, I don't think there's any point in asking them anything. I found this bracelet. It's not yours by any chance, is it? No, but it is pretty. Do you know whose is it? No, sorry, I don't recognize it. About the bracelet, I still don't know who it is. I don't know, but from the looks of it definitely belongs to a girly girl. About the bracelet, I still don't know whose is it is. I've already planned the conversation. Have you lost a bracelet recently? No. Oh no, I lost a bracelet? I'm asking. Oh, I don't think so. I don't wear bracelets. And I'm asking again for Lisander. Is this your bracelet? I already had this conversation also with Melody. Do you know who this bracelet belongs to? Oh, that's Amber's bracelet. What? Amber stole the exams? Yes, no, I didn't say that. It's not Amber's bracelet. I got confused. Yes, you did say that. She left, angry. Poor Nathaniel, I have to go talk to Amber. Amber is over there with her back to me. I don't know how to approach her about this. I lost my bracelet in the dishes dance, and Melody found it. She has been asking everyone whose it is. I better get it back, or she will find out that I'm the one who stole the exams. It was her all along. She just admitted it all by herself. They are still talking. Should I talk to her? Should I try to get out of her of here discreetly? Hey, what are you doing here? Have you been here long? Did you hear us talking? Yes, I heard you stole the exams and are letting Nathaniel take the blame. Why? So that is none of your business. But really, why did you do that? He's your brother. He did nothing to defend me the last time. As any class president, if he wants to take my side, I prefer to see him lose his post. Then he can have me punished. He can't have me punished. You don't know what you're talking about. He has always defended you up until now. Well, you shouldn't have stopped defending me. You know, I have to tell him everything. You've given yourself up on your own. Say that you want, if it doesn't matter because you don't have the exams to prove it. You will still be punished. You are worse than I thought. I'm going to tell Nathaniel right away. Yeah, well, give me my bracelet first. Return the bracelet. Turned around to leave and found face to face with Nathaniel. I guess you heard? Yes, I'm sorry. Betty, can you please try to find the exams? I have to go talk with Emma. Yes, of course. Now is the time that you can actually find the exams. And at this moment, well, you can buy in the dollar shop a magnificent class or something like that. Well, I have already bought it, so it will, because of that, it will. It is not standing anywhere around here, but this is the moment you can buy it, and I will show you how it looks like. Okay, it's not in this item. Here it is. This is what I meant. Sherlock Magnificent Glass. That's what you can buy at the dollar shop at this moment in the episode. And because when I played the movie with Lysander, we had casual, I'm playing now with Lysander, you will also get an item from the fairy that will complete your Sherlock Holmes outfit. So this is the whole Sherlock Holmes outfit. The hat, the pipe, the cape, cap, and the magnificent glasses. Okay. Back to the episode. Excuse me, can you do me a favor? Yes, what? You know my notepad, the one you found the other evening. Did you read it? No, not really. Why? Really things I appreciated. In fact, I'm misplaced again, and I don't really find on anyone to find it and read it. Could you bring it to me if you ever come across it? Okay, as soon as I get the exams back to Nathaniel, I will look around for your notebook. As you can see, the exams are right here. Can I come and watch you guys play someday? No. Oh. Thanks for your interest. I've been looking for you. Here's the sealed envelope with the song. It hasn't been opened yet. Emma didn't open it? What a relief. I can finally get all this off this setup. How are you going to do that? I'm going to put it somewhere in the teacher's house. They will think it just got put in the wrong place. It should work, I think. I hope so, for your sake. And what about Emperor? I'll make sure she gets suspended a couple of days for something or other. She really went too far this time. So you finally going to get revenge on your sister? I don't want to, but I don't see what else I can do. I understand, but I think you're all right. Thanks, I hope she learns her lesson and things will get better. And here is the notebook. Do you have my notepad? Yes, here you are. Thank you very much. Where was it? On a bench in the courtyard. Maybe you left it there between classes. Thanks again, no problem. You, don't move. I was going to go home and Amber is coming at me in a fury. This is the outfit for Casual's illustration and this is the one for Lisandus. And Lisandus is obviously my highest LM and I want to get this illustration, so I'm gonna choose this one. Oh, wait a minute. That looks a lot better. Okay, back to the episode. All of this is your fault. I hope you're happy. I've been suspended for several days. You better watch out. You're going to regret it when I get back. You're the one who's been totally out of line since the beginning. What? Watch what you are going to regret this right now. She's about to slap me. Lisanna came up behind Emma and grabbed her hand before she could slap me. It seems to me, young lady, that we are all responsible for our actions and must assume their consequences. See the illustration. Emma got angry and left without saying a word. Thank you. That was close. No problem. I don't like getting involved in other people's business, but you seemed in need of help. He left. He left. Again. Double, staying there, double. Congratulations, you gave through the defense. You got the surrogate, as I showed you. You can find it in your closet. Congratulations, you find the surrogate pouch during the episode. You can find it with your class and with your clothes. Congratulations, you finished episode 5. So, this was episode 5 of My Candy Love. Thank you all for watching. I hope to see you back in my next video. Maybe until then. Bye!